So I think, as Osmar said, the real data analytics process is a very interactive one, but it's one that we don't typically talk about very much. So it's not, it's very rarely the case someone just gets some data, feeds it through a system, gets an answer, and go away. Typically you get an answer and realise when you've asked the wrong question, or the data's got problems in it, or whatever. So yes, there's a very iterative process, but it's typically not very well supported by the tools we have, and it's not looked at very much by the community. So I think it's actually a very important question which we don't address very well.
Maybe just one another point for the integration. I think there's two things that are important for data science. It's a personal reproducibility, and the second one is traceability. And I'm a little bit afraid that we have a more and more data-dependent society. And if you take some decision using data, maybe you want to trace this decision, to track it, to say, okay, why did you take this decision in this context? So we have more and more powerful visualization tools. And I think one of the problems we have to address is traceability and reproducibility. Are you sure that you took the good decision according to the context? Is it possible to track, to make some kind of traceability of the decision and to know, okay, why did you make this decision?
Okay, I have a question. Actually, we know nowadays it's not sufficient to use traditional time series models to forecast economical data because most of the economical data are so fluctuating. So as a result, most of the researchers develop new hybrid models. So my question is, as a newcomer, how can we define weights to develop hybrid models? And the second question is, how can we know these models are theoretically correct or not? Can you repeat the question? Okay, so we know traditional time series models are not sufficient for forecasting economical data because they are so fluctuating. So most of the researchers develop new models, new hybrid models in Ravi's presentation. Also, he mentioned hybrid models. So I want to know, as a newcomer, how can we develop hybrid models? How can we define weights to develop hybrid models? And how can we know, theoretically, are they correct or not?
So if you get a time series problem, it really depends on the nature of the time series problem. So when you say the classical time series method did not work well, I don't know which method the classical one, because it's a fairly large property of the statistical method which enable you to deal with time series. And in machine learning, there are also a whole full set which you might be able to deal with it. And even in my own domain, traditional computation people also develop a certain tactics in dealing with time series. It depends quite a lot on time series. So it's difficult to come up with one answer for what kind of hybrid method would be better, unless the type B is crashing. Who goes?
Now with the existing value, But we have to go on with the conference. So, I would like to thank you, the panelists, first of all, a lot for accepting our invitation and for contributing to this panel. And I would also like to thank all of you. Of course, tomorrow and this evening, probably this evening during the dinner, no, but tomorrow during the coffee break, you can talk to our expert, at least those of you who will still be here. And, okay, just to end, can you help me? The organizers asked me to give you.
The first one who asked the first one to
So thank you again.